Veefix India YouTube channel. In this video, I am willing to give you information about our recently launched e-classes for mastering LCD panel repairing solutions. Basically, these e-classes are designed for our technician friends, those are involved in the LCD and LED TV sets repairing. In these e-classes, we have included the recent technology LCD panels fault finding process and repairing solutions that will help our technician friends to enhance their knowledge in the field of LCD panel repairing process. Basically, there is total 18 e-classes, each of 90 minutes. We have overall divided these e-classes in 3 segments. From e-class 1 to 8, we have focused on TCON board and scalar PCB repairing and fault finding solutions, and e-class 9 to 11 is focused on the COF IC faults and the solution of the COF IC replacement process. In e-class 12 to 15, we have focused on the panel glass inside circuit problems like jumping picture, scanning line problem, horizontal line problem, etc. We have given all type of solutions with practicals live in the e-classes. In e-class 16, we have focused on the replacement of compatible panel with the any broken panel or not repairable LCD panel. And in e-class 17 and 18, we have taken hands-on practical of live repairing for the typical faults like AVDD is not generating, AVDD salting, VGH or VGL missing, or gamma signals are missing, or CKV line faults. And we have taken some practical bonding solutions in these hands-on practicals. Now, I will show you class 1 to 8 in detail so you can understand how we will going to do knowledge transfer in our e-class. I will show you some parts of our e-classes itself so you will understand how we will do the knowledge transfer in our e-classes. We start with e-class 1 to 8. In that e-class 1 to 8, we start with the motherboard power sequence and the important test point of the motherboard. And after that, how this panel supply PVDD is created from the panel on signal sent by the motherboard controller chip. Basically, as you can see in this practical on the screen, there is two MOSFETs in cascading, and this panel on signal from the motherboard controller switch on the first MOSFET, and this MOSFET switch on the second one, and after that this PVDD is created. So any set with no PVDD, you can easily repair the fault of no panel supply. Then come to the LVDS connector. Basically, there is two type of LVDS connectors with 51 pin or 30 pins. In this LVDS connectors pins, there is panel supply, ground pins, and LVDS data pins. There are different type of LVDS data pairs like 5 pair signals, 10 pair signals, and in these pairs, the RGB data and horizontal sync and vertical syncs are coming as per the ZA format or as per the VESA format or as per the 10-bit panel format or as per the 8-bit panel formats. So we will explain everything in detail what is coming inside these LVDS data pairs. Then some control signals like LVDS mapping, panel ID mapping like SCL, SDA pin, write protect pin, and the bit select pin of 8-bit and 10-bit panels. So every control signals will be explained how it is coming from the motherboard and what is the function and how to alter these control signals for the compatible panel replacement process. After LVDS connector, we will start with the DC to DC IC section. In the DC to DC IC sections, the first step is the creation of 3.3 volt from the panel supply. This 3.3 volt is basically a supply voltage for the TCON IC and the EEPROM of the TCON IC. Now, this 3.3 volt is created using the buck circuit. In this buck circuit, D
DC-to-DC IC supplies a switching pulse, and a combination of inductor coil and diode creates the 3.3 volt using this buck circuit. We will give you the completely practical explanation of working function of the buck circuit, and after creation of this 3.3 volt, the 1.2 volt for the core supply and 1.8 volt for the memory supply is also created from this 3.3 volt. Now the next step is AVDD generation. For the AVDD, there is a boost circuit that generates 15 to 16 volts from the supply of 12 volts. For the same, there is a combination of inductor coil and diode, and a switching pulse from the DC to DC IC is supplied to this boost circuit. And how this boost circuit is happening or working? What is the shape of boosting pulse? That all we will show you in our practicals in the E-class. And also, we will provide you the process of finding the fault if there is no AVDD. And there is an AVDD sorting is there. After AVDD generation, the next step is VGH and VGL creation. In this VGH and VGL generation, the DC to DC IC sends positive drive pulses and negative drive pulses to VGH and VGL departments through a flying capacitors, and these flying capacitors are connected to dual diodes that are known as positive drive pump and negative drive pump respectively. Now, any faults related to the VGH or VGL, we will discuss in these sections, and we will show you practicals on DSO, how these pulses are coming out of DC to DC IC, and also we will explain you how to check some test points using the multimeter as well. After finishing this 3.3 volt AVDD, VGH and VGL generation sections, we will discuss about the feedback circuits. Each of these voltage creation circuit has a feedback to the DC to DC IC. If there is any problem in this feedback circuit, then there is a problem in the voltage output. So we will discuss about the fault related to the feedback circuit as well. We will explain this DC to DC IC circuit all departments using the schematic diagrams, and also we will show you practicals using DSO and multimeter voltage testing points. Now the next section is TCON controller IC. In this TCON controller IC, the basic function is conversion of LVDS data to RSDS data, and that RSDS data is supplied to the source COF or XCOF, and that goes inside the panel glass as a triggering signal to the subpixels line of red, green and blue inside the panel glass. Another function of this TCON controller IC is to generate timing control signals like STV, CPV and OE. You can see on the screen, we are showing you how we are observing these STV, CPV and OE pulses using DSO. In the panel with side gate COF, this STV, CPV, OE and VGH, VGL, etc. signals are going to side gate COF using direct tracks, and in type of panel with no side gate, there is another IC known as level shifter IC or scan drive IC. The function of this level shifter IC or scan drive IC is to create the amplification of VGH and VGL level with the reference of timing control signals like STV, CPV and OE. These analog amplified signals are known as CKV pulses. These CKV pulses are in the pair like CKV1, CKV1, CKV2, CKV-B2, CKV-3, CKV-B3, and in some cases it is CKV-4 and CKV-B4 also. These are also known as HC pulses or clock pulses. Now, these CKV signals are going inside the panel glass gate circuit through the direct tracks of both side last cops. In some set of LCD panel, there is another signals coming out of TCON controller IC that is known as YV1C, and from this YV1C signal, the scan drive IC or level shifter IC creates the signal known as LC1 and LC2, which is a switching signal between the VGH and VGL level. We will show practicals on the faults related to LC1 and LC2 signals. Next is gamma section. In the gamma section, there are two types of gamma IC. One is programmable gamma IC and another one is the non-programmable gamma IC. In the set with non-programmable gamma IC, normally a signal called VREF is created from the AVDD. And from this VREF, using voltage divider networks of resistors, generates gamma signals from the range of 14 volt to 0.4 volt, and these gamma signals are supplied to gamma IC, and gamma IC work as a buffer IC, and this output of gamma IC is going to the source of as a gamma signals. Also, from AVDD, a VCOM signal is generated, and VCOM is also supplied to the source COF as well as the gate circuit on the both side of the LCD panel. Now, in case of programmable gamma IC, the AVDD is supplied to programmable gamma IC, and this programmable gamma IC generates gamma signals directly. There is no voltage divider networks in programmable gamma IC, but if you are replacing a programmable gamma IC or a programmable DC to DC IC, you have to flash the new IC. That means you have to reprogram that new programmable gamma IC or programmable DC to DC IC using a EEPROM programmer. We will show live hands-on practicals for reprogramming gamma IC and DC to DC IC in our E-class number 7. After finishing this department of DC to DC IC, TCON IC, Gamma IC and Scan Drive IC, we will show you different types of most running TCON boards as well as the Scalar PCB, and we will discuss about the most running DC to DC IC and Gamma IC and TCON Controller IC and Level Shifter IC, and we will show you the practicals on this all most running models of these ICs. So, the first section of E-class from 1 to 8 is finished now. Now, we see the class number 9 to 11 that is focused on the COF IC. First, we will start with the faults related to COF IC. How to identify that this fault is related to the COF IC only, and also how to confirm that we will replace the COF and this fault will be 100% solved. So we will give you some practical tips and tricks of pre-observations before the replacement of COF using SCF bonding machine. Also, we will show you how to remove the COF using a specially developed COF removing station. You can see in this video, we are removing this COF glass side and PCB side very easily using this COF removing station. After removing the COF, first you need to clean the tracks of the PCB side and the glass side. We have developed a special method to clean the glass tracks using only a nano sponge and IP chemical without using the SCF removing chemical that damage the glass tracks in some LCD panels. We are using a moving microscope set for live view of glass tracks during the cleaning of glass track process. You can see on the screen we are using a moving microscope setup for live glass track cleaning process. Very easily and very handy method for the fast and safe cleaning of glass side tracks. Next is the cup preparation. First, to cut the cup from the cup roll using a tab cutter. After cutting the cup, we need to apply the SCF tab on the cup. There are two possibilities. One is to apply SCF tab on cup, and another one is to apply SCF tab on glass side directly. Both we will explain you using practicals. Both have some advantages and disadvantages. After SCF apply, we will show you how to do a perfect SCF bonding using the SCF bonding machine. To get a perfect SCF bonding, you should have a proper pressure and proper temperature according to the type of cup. That means if you are using a normal cup around 45 to 50 millimeter width, you should use a standard profile. And if you are doing a bonding with big cup, that is around 65 millimeter width, you need to change the temperature and the pressure of the bonding machine. For the same, we have developed different type of cup bonding profiles in our bonding machines. For big cup, you need to select the big cup profile from the profile selections button. Same way, if you are bonding with 4K panel, in that 4K panel cup, the cup tracks are very thin and dense, very near to each other. You have to select the profile most suitable for the 4K panels. And in some cases, if you are bonding with old cups, then you have to select the profile most suitable for the old cup bonding. So, using the different profile for different type of cups gives you 100% accurate and most strengthful bonding, and that bonding remains long lasting, and there is no possibility or no chance for the lines coming back on the LCD panel after replacement of the cup. In the SCF bonding process, we will also explain you how to maintain SCF bonding machines, like how to do the head cleaning regularly, and also some different parts routine maintenance process we will explain you in some practicals. And also, after making the bonding, how to secure the bonding for long lastings, and how to do the burning test of LCD panel, that we will explain you in the class number 9 to 11. After finishing the bonding section, we will start with class 12 to 15 about the LCD panel inside faults and the working function of LCD panel inside circuit. First, we will explain how the LCD panel works, how the colors are created in LCD panel, and the basic information about the LCD panel working system. We have developed a moving microscope to observe the panel inside circuit, and now you can see on the screen and find the fault in the panel's glass inside circuit. You can see on the screen with using this moving microscope in the X and Y direction, we don't need to move the panel. We move the microscope itself, and now you can see the practical of observing the side gate tracks from the side gate cuff. These tracks are coming out of side gate and going to the source cuff tracks. You can see this practical on your screen now. Also, the same way, here you can see the CKV line observations. These CKV lines are going to the both side of LCD panel, and from the both side, these CKV lines are going to SR block circuit, and from this SR block circuit output, it converts in the gate line, that is known as Y line or horizontal line. So any faults related to the CKV lines or the CKV line leakage, you can observe using this moving microscope. You don't need to move panel. Also, you can observe the bonding area, after the bonding process, or also you can observe the data lines coming out of the source cuff and going inside the panel to the RGB subpixels vertical lines. You can see on the screen that we are observing the RGB subpixels data lines using this moving microscope. In this way, this microscope is very useful for observing the all type of LCD panel glass inside circuits. And the main benefit of the observation is that you will find the exact cause of fault, and also you can do the glass track cleaning during the SCA bonding process live by viewing on this microscope, and there is no possibility of damage to the glass side tracks when you are doing glass side tracks cleaning like this. After panel glass circuit inside observations and we have some idea about the cause of fault, we can do some alterations in CKV lines for the faults like jumping picture or Y lines on the LCD panel. For the same, we have developed a special method to cut the CKV lines, and step by step method. So you need to cut very few CKV lines. You don't need to cut all CKV lines. So the picture quality we try to maintain as much as better after CKV line cutting as well. And in some cases, if you are finding a scanning line problem in LCD panel, we will have a special method to remove this scanning line using some alterations in the CKV line tracks. That all we have included in our E-class number 12 to 15. In E-class 16, we have taken practicals on the changing LCD panel with compatible one. We will show how to do LVDS mapping, that means the switching between the ZR mapping and VESA mapping. Also, in the Sony TV sets, we will show how to do the panel ID matching with the new panel installed using SDL and SCL connections of external EEPROM to the new panel. Also, we will show you how to use the bit select signal for the matching of 8-bit and 10-bit panel types, and also we will see how to do a mirror solution, that means the vertical picture mirroring solution using some alteration in TCON and scalar PCB circuits. In E-class 17 and 18, we are taking hands-off practicals of live repairings. Most of typical faults like no AVDD, no 3.3 volt creation, AVDD sorting problem, gamma IC not giving output, level shifter IC CKV or LC signals are not coming out, or faults related to the CKV leakage, that means the jumping picture, and some faults related to the bonding of different type of cops, we will take as a live practical repairing, and we will show the solution of this type of faults in the E-class number 17 and 18. Friends, as you have seen, our E-classes are full of practicals, and after going through these E-classes and gains the new fault finding process methods and the working of LCD panel circuits, you will have your own method to find the faults and to repair the faults, and I am sure that you will be able to handle the difficult level of LCD panel faults as well, and your repairing efficiency of LCD panel will be increased very much. This E-classes from 1 to 18, we called these E-classes as Pro version. We have another advanced level of version that we called as the ultimate version. In the ultimate versions, there are three additional features are given. The first feature is the panel glass inside circuit understanding and fault finding process at deep level. Normally, the person who is using the laser machine for LCD repairing or the person who want to buy a laser machine for LCD panel repairing process should go with the ultimate version of glass. In the ultimate version, we will give hands-on practicals of LCD panel glass inside circuit faults repairing using the laser machine's operations like CKV cutting, the leakage in the CKV lines, scanning line solutions, jumping pictures that is not solved after the CKV line cutting, and also Y line, that means the horizontal line solutions repairing using the laser machines. The another feature of ultimate version of E-classes is that we assign one technical person to whom you can make a video call and he will assist you during any of faults you are repairing and you have some problem in the troubleshooting of that particular case. So you can make a video call to our technical assistant and our assistant will guide you how to do the troubleshooting and the solution of the fault step by step using the video call process.
The third feature in ultimate version is the support for the spare part procurement. In this, we will share our worldwide contacts which we have gathered with our years of experience for different type of spare parts like motherboard, scalar PCB, TCON board, COF IC, backlight and even for new panels, which we will share with you, and from that resources you will be get genuine spare part with very less time. So overall your repairing speed and the response to your customer will be increased with support of our spare part procurement resources sharing. So friends, the three main features of ultimate version of E-classes are training of LCD panel repairing with laser machine, online technical assistance with video calling support, and the third is the spare part resources sharing. Friends, I hope that you will join our pro version or ultimate version E-classes and you will enhance your technical knowledge and eventually you will increase your repairing efficiency in your service center. Friends, thank you very much for watching this video, and for any query or doubt you may have about the technical knowledge transfer process, you can join our demo e-class that is free of cost, and also you can subscribe our YouTube channel for getting new technological updates. Hope to see you soon on our e-classes. Thank you very much.